Welcome to Mint Views after the Diwali break. As news came in on Diwali night, the dreaded chief of the Islamic State, Abu Bakr Al Baghdadi, the self-styled caliph of a global caliphate, in their view, was killed in a US raid somewhere on the Turkish border in northwestern Syria. We only have America's word for it, but as it turns out, as America is saying, the man blew himself up along with his three children. He was, of course, a dreaded and dangerous man. Now, the question is, does this, the killing of Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, spell the end of a virulent and extremist form of ideology that was threatening the world? Is this the end? That's the question we'll debate today. What do you think, Shrija?
Baghdadi is definitely very important, given that he was considered to be the head of the Hydra of the foundation. But this doesn't necessarily mean that it's an end of the ISIS movement. If you see the condition of the states in terms of the governance, in terms of the economy, in terms of the internal civil strife that's constantly happening, people out there are very easily disenchanted or disenfranchised, which kind of makes them, veer towards this this caliphate or this ideology which promises a heaven or a sort of a luxury for them.
You mean this movement is probably likely to survive because it's an ideology which may or may not actually need a central figurehead, you think, a caliph himself, which of course was absurd. Anyway, what do you think, Anant? Are we seeing the end of IS at the end of this problem on the whole?
I think she is right that this might have become a self-propelling machinery. Mm-hmm. And you don't necessarily need a head to be operating, because after all, when Bin Laden was killed, we thought that that would be the end of his organization, but there have been threats that have emerged after that as well. But what I'm more concerned about is the impact this would have on India. Mm-hmm. And in India, I think there have been intelligence inputs that there is possibly the presence of ISIS in some of the states. We've seen some youth from Kerala getting swayed by ISIS ideology. We've given the sensitivity of these particular states and the kind of threats that India faces. I think we need to be on a high alert for a prolonged time to ensure that they don't re-emerge.
Mm-hmm. Thankfully, the numbers are minuscule. I think the Kerala numbers are just a handful, and we don't have evidence of a surge towards IS in any sense. What do you think, Srijay?
That's correct, Harish. In any case, the numbers that have actually gone on to join the ISIS from India have been very small. Besides, I think it's a very, very lethal blow to this entire organization itself. You see, for any movement to sustain, you actually need a very charismatic leader, as well as the strength of financial resources, which the ISIS now has lost in the form of its head being killed. And it has lost control over several oil wells that it had gone to capture during its heydays. So to that extent, I think it may not have been eliminated totally, but they will take a long, long time, if at all, to regroup once again.
Well, the interesting thing is that the sheer horrors committed by this group, IS, have thoroughly discredited this particular group as representative of the Islamic world in general. The ideology is Islamist rather than Islamic. And as a result, I have a feeling that their actual support base worldwide has been rapidly falling. But on the other hand, there will always be extreme forms of thought on radicalized sides of the spectrum, which could possibly create dangers, which is what we need to watch out for.
The organization has taken even some roots in India. Then just the elimination of the head won't really change the scenario on the ground over here.
The thinking that went behind ISIS or IS may mutate and find itself emerge or express itself in new forms in different parts of the world, hopefully not in India. We do have to keep watch. The death of a charismatic leader, while it's a severe blow to the organization, will it completely eliminate the problem? Most certainly not. Does it reduce the threat? It certainly does. Where the threat level currently lies is probably in the hands of those who have to fight against the very ideology. And that's what we hope should happen. Thank you.